You're ready for some Witcher.
Really? It optimizes it fine for me.
Just tells me it can't be optimized. Nothing more. Oh well, even more time wasted. At least the FPS counter works. Cool. Alright.
What a shame.
Mm-hmm.
Damien could be in danger.
Or dead.
Do you think so? He's seen battle-hardened. More than a few scraps under his belt.
Against humans, not monsters.
Alright. Let me do some more settings real quick, because I want to get this fucking done right. Should be able to get something like this, maybe? No. That's terrible.
Let's go to Captain Mustache.
Options video. How about this? No. I want to get buttery smooth FPS of at least 30 consistently. Has to be done. Okay. Yeah, hold on. People are dying, I know, but FPS, bro. Yeah.
Care to come back?
No. Whoa, 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 he just started floating. Running away from my problems, bro. 30 stable-ish. Is there anything else I can turn off? Blur. Do one. I don't understand why I can't, like, select how much anti-aliasing there is. Vignetting. Fuck is that? You want my chance. Can I turn that off, maybe?
Lesser vampires would heed a higher vampire's call and commands.
As a rule, they don't.
So how Detloff sick them on the city?
I told you, he's exceptional. He manages to bend them to his will, control them with his thoughts. They'll continue attacking until he orders them to back down, or until he dies.
Who is that? Mother Brusca. I don't have time for this. Why don't you help, bro? Yeah, I guess we're just running away then. Fine.
Oh,
useless. Claws slice through steel like through butter.
We must hurry. Each moment's delay means another death.
They broke formation, ran.
That scent. It's Damien's blood. He was wounded.
Let's go.
Cool. Why is the objective pointer so... What is going on?
Geralt, care to come back?
Yeah, I would, but... You're not moving.
This is why Geralt doesn't wear a helmet. Monsters just cut through it like butter.
What the fuck is going on with you, game?
Come back.
I would! If the objective unfucked itself, I would, if that actually happened. This is so weird.
Barricade put up in the street.
Pointless. That's an obstacle to a vampire.
They didn't know. I didn't get a chance to prepare them.
Maybe you need to look at the burnt guy.
That's fucking... whatever. Ah, fucking Brux.
Never mind then.
Time to end this.
No, Geralt, stop with the fisticuffs.
Barricaded themselves inside.
Clearly you just failed to hit some invisible objective marker.
And I'm almost dead. Oh my god, stop it, dude.
If you die, it's game over. So
you
please don't die.
Single-handedly? That harlot's brood slaughtered half my unit.
I see the harlot's brood came close to slaughtering you as well.
Need to withdraw. You and your men. Now.
My duty lies with the city.
Won't help the city by leading your men to the slaughter. Damien, conversation back at the palace, remember? I'll say it again. Your men don't stand a chance.
Regis is not very reliable with his help.
Men, tend to the wounded and prepare to march out.
Doing the right thing. Now listen close. Silver. That's what you want to use against vampires. Your alchemists order them to produce as much vampire oil as they can, churn it out in gallons, then coat your blades with it. Keep an eye out for Alps and Bruxae. The shapely ones resemble women. There one moment, gone the next. Bombs containing silver splinters are a pretty good idea.
Thank you, Witcher. I hope you're worth the coin the Duchess pledged you. And that you'll return with the head of the wretch that did this, skewered on a hook.
Got a different plan.
And what would that be?
All I can say just now is I'm gonna need Sianna.
You know the Duchess's decision. Sianna awaits her trial, in custody.
We know it, but we do not agree with it.
You've that luxury. I do not. I've sworn my loyalty to her grace.
Can't force you, won't try. But I'd urge you to ask yourself a question. How you feel tomorrow when you bury more soldiers while knowing you might have prevented their deaths, but chose not to even try.
I fear we waste our time here. Come, Geralt.
Wait. When last I saw Sianna, Her Grace was escorting her to the palace playroom.
Playroom? As in, for children? You sure?
I've served in the Ducal Palace for years. I know its every corner. So yes, I am damn sure.
Playroom? So what, Duchess Loxiana up in a dollhouse?
Honestly, I've no clue. Look, I've told you what I saw. What you do with it is no concern of mine.
Got it. I'll look into it. You get back to your barracks. Retrace my steps. Path ought to be clear.
Not really. I left a bunch of Broxia in the way, so good luck with that.
And you've our gratitude. You helped us a great deal.
I helped Beauclair. At least I hope I did.
Let's go.
Let's go, Regis.
Oh, shit. Feeling is returning to my face finally after.
Here, the playroom's behind this door.
4 hours? Or so? Christ. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Well, thanks, I guess. Why did it switch my objective around, game? What are you
That's
doing?
That's great news.
Fuck off.
Should have used fisticuffs.
Locked. Of course. Regis, rather not have a fist fight with his door. Do you mind?
I would have had a fist fight with the door.
Thanks.
At your service.
Do we really have time for bows?
Utter silence. No one here.
We should look around.
I thought vampires couldn't enter uninvited.
It's all bullshit. Ooh, it's a glow. Gnomish prackings. Scrub the greasings from a dog's ear, soak into cotton twine, place in a new lamp of greenish hue, and set said lamp betwixt an eager crowd. Forsooth, shall they swear that a dog's head they behold, and this shall be no sorcery, but good bet-tidings. Bet-tidings? Bet-tidings? For the Prince of Illander's nuptials, a paltry gnome armed with a miniature cutlass behind himself in a pie. When guests partook of this princely banquet, anon jumped out the besabred gnome, giving a terrible fright to all at first, then causing much merriment once the jest was figured. A cinephalus, or a doghead in our tongue, a beast that in the waste of Zanguibar dwells, has the corpus of a man but the head of a dog. The Prince of Elander did receive such a specimen from those far-off lands. The cinocephalus lets stream its urine with the tolling of every hour, both day and night, and this is why the Sanguibarians engrave its likeness on timepieces and compasses. I have no idea what I just read. Sure, anyway.
Something inside?
Anon was messing with gnomes, that rascal.
Drinking some milk, so that's good.
Miniature tableware and plush toys. Cute. Wooden duck. Somebody broke its wings off.
Rather worn. I suppose it got a lot of use.
Nice tune.
Indeed. Pleasant. It's a shame the mechanism's damaged.
What the? Found a notebook. Property of Isabelle de Roquefort, court governess. The notes of Sienna and Anna Henrietta's governess when they were little.
I'm not sure it will help, but I suppose there's no harm in leafing through them.
Except wasting time, but sure, whatever.
Sienna gave me a drawing today.
Charming.
Of freshly decapitated bodies covered in blood.
Perhaps not so much.
I asked her why ever she would draw such a thing. Her Highness claimed it was a rendering of nightmares which have plagued her for as long as she can remember. Sienna does wake up screaming nearly every night, save when she shares a bed with Honorietta.
And your vampire dude liked this lady?
What the fuck? Girls affected by it had horrible dreams. Kind of horrible that made some of them go mad. The girls quarreled today. I must note rather sadly they did not behave as befits future ladies. The incident devolved into fisticuffs.
Fisticuffs!
Henrietta was first to strike her sister. Sienna gave back as good as she'd gotten. By the time I separated them, Henrietta had lost two teeth. She ran off to complain to her parents. His Grace the Duke
Birds of a feather flock together.
He laid all the blame on Sienna and vowed to punish the little one harshly. Henrietta did her best to have her sister's sentence commuted, but the Duke and Duchess proved unbending.
Once you're labeled a black sheep, it's so hard to shed that reputation.
Today I accompanied the girls for the first time to the Land of a Thousand Fables. We spent half the day there. First we played with Thumbelina, then with Barbarossa, who proved quite the charmer for a brigand and pirate.
I'm beginning to suspect Isabel de Roquefort wrote in her diary after taking a powerful hallucinogenic. Cannabis rudolaris, for instance, or...
Shh, don't interrupt.
Dude, weedle,
my cap to Master Artorius Vigo for his achievement. He has proved he has no equal in the arcane arts.
Wait, Artorius was the court mage here, a specialist in illusions, which means...
Regis, last warning. Stop interrupting or I'll seat you in the corner. The girls told me, if I ever wish to visit alone, I need but crack open the Land of a Thousand Fables and utter out loud the incantation, Expecto Ludum.
A book as the key to an illusion. My, my, this grows more interesting by the minute.
Mages sent by the Conclave arrived today. They came to examine Sienna. I cannot know what conclusions they drew, but His Grace now seems clearly upset.
Curse of the Black Sun. There's no doubt then that she was diagnosed with the syndrome symptoms.
Or had that label planted on her. It goes on. I dared ask the Duke what would become of the girl. He did not reply. Mages sent by... I cannot... Or happy... I tutored the girls in Nilfgaardian today. Sienna applies herself so, though she has great difficulty memorizing new vocabulary. Lady Honorietta seems more gifted in this regard, yet also prone to impish behavior. When she thought me out of earshot, she called me a blood accuser. She and Sienna laughed so hard she almost choked. Bluda is damned. Or cursed. What's accuser?
In the melodious tongue of our none too friendly neighbors to the south, the word describes the many petaled flower that blooms in that place we so unmelodiously call the crotch.
Realize this might sound improbable, but maybe, just maybe, Anna Henrietta tossed Sienna into that illusion.
Not impossible. She would be safe there, and isolated. We must see.
Where's that book?
Time to loot.
A tin knight. Nothing under the carpet.
Did you expect something? Apart from the dust swept under there by a lazy chambermaid.
Locked. A tin knight.
Yeah, girl, we saw that already.
Well, well. A key tucked behind a picture.
I'll come in, kidink.
Is it? Let's see. Expecto Ludum.
Oh my god! Mist is real.
Regis.
Expecto Patronum.
Expecto Assum.
Land of a thousand fables. Incredible.
Geralt in Wonderland.
Let's see where this road takes me. I have Nahelene is going wild. The whole land's an illusion. It's so powerful, there's no way to dispel it.
Geralt is gonna go snickersnack.
Whee! Controls are all fucky for some reason. I can't. Okay. It was weird. Just got stuck in Witcher mode. Oh boy.
Nope. Die.
Gross.
Damn it. And this is a playground for two little girls. Something's not right.
Whee!
Bloody hell, let him out!
Voices.
He gobbled up my gingerbread! Now it's my turn to gobble him!
Hey.
Hands off my hearth, dearie. You wouldn't want me to get cross.
Then I hope Baba Yaga is home.
What a nice old lady.
Supposed to be.
That's a nice nose.
Why, you're old. Old and pale. But never worry. A bit of butter, a bit of spice, and you'll make a tasty morsel. Just as soon as I catch you.
Okay. Sure. Whoa. Probably need to shoot her. Except I don't have the... Why don't I have a thing? Is this actually... Weird. Yeah, you're having a good time. That's nice and all, but...
You notice her shield goes out whenever she's splashing her suit.
I know, dude. That's what I've been trying to do. What's going on? Geralt, can you move? Thanks. Okay.
Hey.
Oh, it's a panther. Come on, you wicked bitch.
Panthers, this isn't how the fairy tale goes.
This is so silly. Fuck.
Should destroy her brew.
Ah, shit! Fucking... I didn't have point up. That was... my problem. Come on, do it.
Do it.
Do it.
What the hell was that?
The Wicked Witch. You've heard of her, haven't you? Now, where did you put that key?
Listen, I... how'd you come by a weapon?
It's Prince Charming's. He no longer needs it. Here it is.
Thank you. She'd have begged me for certain if you'd not... Sienna? Is that you?
It's been years, Jack.
Have you come to play?
No, I just want your beans, so you can breathe easy.
Breathe easy? Because you aren't here to play? What's that about?
Jack knows what I mean, so he'll tell me where the beans are as fast as he can.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Put the beans on it.
Sienna, I'm sorry, but I haven't got them.
By the way,
something tells me you're lying.
Jelly beans are fucking
perhaps
disgusting.
You wish to play the old games after all.
I don't understand
this little
why people, some people like them so much.
This little picky.
But first, we need to kill a giant.
Instance. I'm telling the truth. I swear it. Anarieta, she ordered them buried all over so you wouldn't be able to leave.
Where?
I don't know. But Joss, The boy with the think for wolves. He should know. He sticks his nose in everyone's affairs.
He had better know. Because if not, I'll find you and we'll have ourselves a little talk. Understand? Now shoo! Ah, all right. So why is it you're here?
Searching for my lost childhood.
Is he saying Joss Fox Wolves?
Little boy, don't quite remember how. Never had any toys, never played any games. What do you think? Why might I be here? It's Dedlof. He's trying to force Anna Henrietta's hand. Wants her to release you. Summoned monsters to attack Beauclair.
Sounds like Dedlof, all right. But I doubt you came all this way just to bring me up to speed on current events. So get to the point, please.
Isn't it obvious? Offering to be your ally. We both want you out of here. You because you want your freedom back. Me because as soon as you meet with Dedlof, he'll put an end to the chaos in the city.
You exposed me. I landed in prison because of you. Now you come to beg my help, I dare say. My life is full of surprises, isn't it? But normally I'd tell you to sod off. But, from what you say, folk are dying who have nothing to do with this. Not part of the plan. Dedlof was only to kill those who deserved it. No one else. Fine, Witcher. I accept your offer. Consider us allies. Shake on it.
Curse of the Black Sun.
This wasn't part
That's
of her Kikaku.
Right?
Kikaku. Princesses, mutants. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Even met one of you. Renfri of Craydon.
And? Was she truly monstrous?
She was cruel, that's certain. But what caused it? The curse or what she went through? Asking myself to this day.
You killed her, didn't you?
Had no choice.
Funny. Mum said the same when she tossed me out of the house.
Since you brought it up, the knights Dedlof killed. What exactly did they do to you? Crespi, Duhak, Lacroix, Peyrek Peyron?
Not a memory I enjoy revisiting, but I suppose you deserve to know. When my parents disowned me, they ordered those very knights to escort me beyond the duchy's borders. All did so without uttering a single word in my defense.
Like you said, they had their orders.
Mm-hmm. But Crespi was not ordered to beat me unconscious with a horsewhip after my first attempt at escape. And Ulak had no instructions to deny me food and abuse me. I learned something then. Knights are not so chivalrous when no one's watching.
That explains a lot.
Shocked, aren't you? You must have thought you had me pegged. Before bothering to hear my side. Everyone does that.
This place. Tell me something more. It's an illusion, right?
Yes. Created by Artorias Vigo. Anna Henrietta and I would come here to play out scenes from our favorite fables.
Which didn't seem like she was playing.
Magical entropy. Without maintenance, the spell gradually disintegrates over time. It grows wild.
Your sister chose a dangerous place for your prison.
It's deceptive. Provided I don't provoke them, the fairy tale characters don't attack me. But you don't belong here. So you had best be on your watch.
So, what's with the beams? Mind explaining?
Certainly. But you must gird yourself with patience. There are two ways out of this land. My darling sister blocked one when she tossed me in here. The other's up there, in the clouds. She made it hard, but not impossible to access by concealing the beans.
Still don't understand.
Don't fret, just listen. That boy, that was Jack, of Beanstalk fame. You know the tale?
Jack climbed a gigantic beanstalk to a giant's castle, high up in the clouds.
As we shall do if we can just find those blasted beans. There are three. One red, one blue, one yellow.
Stalk won't sprout from just one?
No, because it must transpire exactly as it did in the tale. Clear now? So we must find Joss. Perhaps he will be able to help us. You lead.
Okay. Hold on, though.
Joss can usually be found wandering the glade at the foot of the mount. It's some distance from here, past the witch's house to the right.
Okay.
This is hello, Geralt.
Ah.
Are we gonna find the Smurfs too?
Why is she marked as an enemy, though? Or what's going on here? Why is there an enemy on my map? That's weird.
This is no time to chat. We must find Joss.
Sure, whatever, man.
So, what exactly is happening in the city?
Bloodshed, a massacre, which is why we gotta hurry.
You needn't fight. Time flows differently on Fogel Street. We can stay here a week, yet outside, mere minutes will have passed.
How convincing. I fucking remember these things. They're poplets, though, not pixies.
Not good.
Yeah.
Not the friendliest pixies I've met.
Put here to protect the Fable Sphere from intruders, meaning you.
Not very good protectors.
Oh, unicorns! We must catch them. We won't have to walk everywhere then. I call the pink one.
How do I sneak again?
Oops. Exciting, isn't it? Reminds me of my childhood.
Reminds me of something altogether different.
Care to elaborate?
Rather not.
No wolves here. None at all. This is grand. I'm all right. Not in any danger. That's him. Joss. Last, they're going to rip them in six.
Nice, dude. What happened with that rule?
Nice that they brought back the Unicorn Joe from the beginning.
Dude, what?
Relax, it's over.
This part of the game is kind of really buggy.
Another wolf behind you. Ignore him, he always lies.
Aha, boy who cried wolf. Still does, I suppose. And doesn't, when they actually appear.
The one and only. Listen, you little chit. Jack said you know what's
going on with the
three beans. I don't know anything! Not one thing, and besides, watch out! Wolves!
This'll be interesting. Right, let's get to it. Let's say for a minute you know what happened to the red bean. Where wouldn't it be?
For certain, no one swallowed it. Oh no, definitely not that!
Of course not. But say someone didn't. Who would it be that didn't swallow it?
A human! The most human human in the land of a thousand fables!
Wouldn't you have to negate again? Who wouldn't it be that didn't? But whatever.
Bet you haven't heard what happened to the blue bean. Maybe? Not at all? Right?
I've heard it lies about somewhere. Out in the open.
Just like that? No one guarding it?
Nobody.
Three times over! Help! Wolves!
You're a fucking idiot.
Yellow Beam. Don't know a thing about it, right?
It's somewhere very, and I mean very deep. So deep, in fact, it's completely underground.
And who has it,
A bold farmhand, who in no way and not at all awaits someone. Not in the slightest. Good folk! Wolf!
Say that word one more time and I'll chop you up. Feed you to the fishes. Understood?
Later, all right, kiddo.
We should go.
Watch out for wolves!
Tough to talk to, that one.
Was it, though? You need merely remember he always lies. Or more precisely, refers us the truth.
Where to now?
I'm not sure. We should visit some of the other fables. The meaty ones, that is. Perhaps then Joss's hints will make more sense. It's just a few. Red Riding Hood, piglets and bears, three of each. And Goldilocks, of course. Then Longlocks and a little lass who sells flint.
Fine. Let's get to
work. Is the yellow bean in the tower over there?
Geralt. I love you.
Incredible. You must have loved this place.
I did at first. But children get bored quickly. Even tea parties with a whole cackle of princesses eventually turn dull and routine.
Spaghetti becomes a routine. Where's she going? Lady, where are you going? The fuck? Did she just take off on her own?
What did you do then?
Dropped a duck egg in the swan's nest once.
Fine, we'll that's go this way then.
Stole the pee out from the princess.
Oh my god. Is this really
spaghetti
necessary? Spaghetti.
No one. They need me.
Call mine, bro.
Roach? Are you serious?
This is Longlocks Tower.
Indeed.
What John said about the third beam, remember?
In the possession of a bold farmer, deep beneath the ground. Yes, this must be it. Let's go.
Go where? Tower, I guess? Sure, whatever.
Never
always grapple
up her brain.
But
see
it anyway.
We'll find another way out. Could pull myself up here, and I'll have to make that jump.
If you say so, I shall wait down here if it's all the same. Climbing's not my strong suit.
That camera really wanted me to see that rainbow. Not quite what I wanted. Geralt's old man knees gave in again. Tower. Oh, okay.
Game wanted you to now dash and look at the rainbow. Cool, she hanged herself. Now that's a fairy tale I can get behind.
Lots of fairy tales, like old ones, are fucking grim as shit. Rip. That's pretty metal, though. Yeah.
Yellow beam.
Very metal.
There it is. Would have stumped to climb all that way for nothing.
Expensive toys. Let's have a look at the view as well, shall we? I'm gonna quick
yes,
save.
Yes, most are grim.
Oh, this is inviting. That would have fucking killed him.
So?
Got the bean, but long logs. Seems she got sick of waiting for a knight in shining armor.
Can you blame her? Men these days, dandies and fops all.
That why you nice cozy up to a vampire?
Dead laugh.
Water doesn't hurt.
And only a tool.
Too bad he didn't know that.
I trust no one. Learned that long ago. Now it's his turn.
To use him.
You obtained
was that
a
your
Cheeto.
Plan from the start?
No. At first I was simply intrigued. Do you know the story? It was in Matina. A few years passed. I'd gone there to pass some loot off to a fence I know. We were hashing out the terms when in walked Detlaf. He said he'd come to sell a silver candlestick. He gripped it through a cloth. That caught my eye. I followed him out, observed him from a distance, but he caught on quickly.
Yeah, superhuman senses will do that.
He turned down a blind alley. I followed. He jumped out from behind a crate, baring his teeth. I suppose he'd wanted to frighten me. Alas, he didn't in the least. After all, I'm a monster too, am I not?
What happened then?
We talked, then met up once, twice, three times. Enough that he became infatuated. I truly enjoyed it at first, but only at first. He did not love like a man. But like an animal, madly, deeply, unconditionally, wildly. To return such a feeling, anyone would be hard-pressed. Let alone someone as twisted as I am.
So there came a day you just up and disappeared.
Yes. There was no other way. Let's just be friends, or I don't deserve you. He'd never have understood that sort of thing. But then, once I decided to return, clean up some old affairs, I remembered him, and concluded he could still be of use.
Playing with fire, that.
Definitely. And either I'll get burned, or I'll burn all else down. No other options.
Got a history with Detlaf now. So this meeting will be different. Not afraid?
I can handle him.
Mm-hmm. Sure about that?
You look at him as a witcher and see a monster. I know what he's really like. You needn't worry. It's time to go.
Detlaf just got friend zoned. We'll truly, nice guys finish last.
There's my horse. Roach. Whoops. How do I roach again? I forget. X. Get over here, dude. There we are. A roach.
Do you think Roach entered this world with you?
Oh, that's fucking sweet ass cat. Shit.
Oh, you meant Unicorn Roach.
Nice cat.
Care for a cigarillo? A bit of tobacco? A dab of fistech?
Remind me, what tale are you from?
Sword Flint's when I was a lass. but no one bought them, so I branched out. Now I deal in snuffs, puffs, all sorts of fun things. What'll you have, sweeties?
Magic Hit me up.
Do you have any?
That cat it's has not nice name boots.
Of some kicker I already have, dearies. Then no. But maybe you'd like some.
Hey, where'd you get that ribbon? That's mine.
Is that so? Then why was it lying in the bushes? Finders keepers, sweetheart.
The ribbon. Mind explaining what the fuss
she
is
also
about?
Sells
There's
bait.
Not much to explain. I got it from Aturius Vigo when I was a child. It was to protect me from evil. It clearly didn't work, given how I ended up.
But it means a lot to you.
How should I put this? I have so few mementos from my childhood, and the ribbon reminds me of the good old days, when I was someone else.
Dears, could you continue this touching scene elsewhere, You're scaring away my customers.
What customers? It's only you.
Give Sienna the ribbon. Why not, huh?
Sugar plum. The only thing I hand out for free is a first hit. To get them to come back for a second, of course. For all else, you've got to pay.
What if I asked you nicely?
Ask me nicely and I might play you for it. A round of cards?
Ah, fuck it.
Fine. I'll pay you for the ribbon. This enough?
It's enough. Now go away.
No, I need to sell you my shit. Hold on.
The kids in this DLC are obsessed with profit.
Oh, okay, I guess I can't.
All right. Tell me.
What?
What you want in return. You're not doing this out of the kindness of your heart.
Don't want anything in return.
I... Thank you.
Can't even buy a phantom cigar, bah.
Whoa! Man, I really need to play Metal Gear Solid 5. Fuck yeah,
oh, Rami. Three little pig songs. You know the story, don't you? Who's afraid of the big bad wolf?
Looks like Big Bad's already blown down the houses of straw and sticks. Brick's the only one left.
We should look inside. Remember Joss's words?
One bean lies out in the open, guarded by three nobodies. Yeah, could be it.
Yeah, that's one bean down. Good work.
Yeah.
That's Witcher.
What are you doing? Oh, I guess I need to blow it down or something. Oh, okay. What the fuck? Holy shit!
Oh, they didn't like that.
Oh my god! These pigs are fucking tough as nails.
I like the hat. This is the best.
So dumb.
Oh look, the Emperor of Newton. He's come out to show off his new role. Ugly end,
Holy shit! These things are fucking tough. Yo, dude, there's a naked one. What are you doing that? Hold on now. Magic dust. That rainbow is gonna kill me.
The big bad Witcher huffed and puffed, and look, got a beam.
It cannot be.
What cannot be?
You actually have a sense of humor.
Stunted a bit, but yeah, it's there.
Well, well, aren't you full of surprises? What else are you hiding behind that gruff exterior?
Not a bad singer. Do a pretty mean rendition of The Maids of Vicovaro, for instance. But some other time, maybe.
Oh my god, can you imagine Geralt as doing karaoke?
When there's work to
Holy
do.
Shit!
We must keep looking.
That would be the best thing. I need to see this.
So,
make it happen,
like it
somehow.
No, got a problem with magic in general. Illusions, portals, all that. Don't trust any of it.
A bow of old-fashioned tastes, eh? I like that.
Is she coming on to me? Also, my sword is broke, so let me just fix that up. Wait, was that the wrong sword? I guess it was. Gotta get more of those repair kits. Motherfucker. Oh, it healed me anyway, so thanks for that. What's this? A pond.
Did you like Anna Henrietta?
Do you jest? I adored her. My darling little sis. So adorable. So sweet. Yet when they banished me from the palace, she didn't so much as peek out of the window.
She might not have known. Maybe just couldn't.
And could she also not grant me amnesty when she was crowned? Please.
Hello? Can we talk?
Schmumbotch, my head! Damn it all! I swear that was the last time I drank with Redbeard. Oh, Sianna. A bloody long time it's been. You've changed.
Whereas you, not at all, big bad wolf. Though it seems you've started running with the wrong crowd.
And who should I run with, eh? Thumbelina? One shot and she's under the table. But the best, what brings you?
Listen, looking for magic beans. See any?
I was given one for safekeeping, but...
Where is it? Talk!
Shh, not so loud.
Oh, I can be much louder than this. And resort to other means of persuasion.
Right there, the threats! Sienna to a T. Listen,
Big Bad Wolf parties hard.
I exist to restage a fairy tale. If you want to play at it, I'll be happy to oblige. But it won't be easy. The thing is, Little Red Riding Hood's popped her clogs.
What?
1,000 times they cut my gut open, filled it full of rocks and drowned me in the river. So once you stopped coming, I decided to repay the little imp for all her loving labor. Who now rots at the bottom of the well, she and the hunter, which means we can't play, and I'm under no obligation to talk to you, not about beans, nor anything else. So leave me be. Sod off.
Nice.
So, what now?
Don't worry. I'll play with him. Or rather, play him. I just need that little red hood. The piece of apparel, that is. Not the poor girl's corpse.
That's a relief.
You wish to help me? Here's your chance. Jump in the well and fish it out. Well, chop chop.
Huzzah!
Right. Time to jump in the well.
Break a leg.
How do I dive again? Because I forget. It's not V. It's not F. Definitely not F. Oh, it's down there. Never mind. I'm a dumbass. Nice.
Any luck?
Yep.
No.
Look what I got.
Look.
That would never fit you. Give it to me.
Aw, oh, sweet.
I like when a video game has underwater caves.
Fuck yeah. Sure, why not?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Let's go see the big bad wolf.
Let me guess. You'll play the granddaughter.
Mm-hmm. And you, the hunter.
You again? I thought I was clear. I will not talk to you.
There are the animals, but we're a bandit.
Not a problem. Sienna can take her place.
What? Very well. It's not as if I can forbid you. Granddaughter, come closer, sweetie.
But Grandmama, what big eyes you have.
They're better to see you with, my dear.
Granny, what big arms you have.
They're better to embrace you with, my dear.
And Grandmama, what big teeth you have, eh?
The better to eat you with, my dear!
Alright, let's kill the Frenchman. Oh, he's a fast one. Holy shit, he's fast. whoa, whoa, whoa! Fucking Christ!
Play traps.
French Wolf is a pretty cool dude.
Yeah, traps is actually a good idea for this. Let's eat some gingerbread.
Seems the stomach injury doesn't hamper him.
Holy shit, how am I still alive? I drank something I shouldn't have. Oh my god. Well, there he goes. Another thing. I still fuck Gwen. Ah shit. Dude, stop it. Don't go into the cave. Please, girl.
Joss said about the red bean. A human has it, and he definitely didn't swallow it.
Mm-hmm. Gotta open his belly. Bottle caps, fake teeth, a corkscrew. Ah, here it is. Red bean.
Ah, cool. At last we have them all.
What?
Now I find myself wondering if you're just horribly discreet, or if those mutations completely scrubbed away your curiosity. Are you really not interested in what happened? In what became of me after they cast me out?
Well, since you brought it up, I'd gladly hear the rest. Let's see. They escorted you out of the duchy.
Yes. And the noble knights of Toussaint and I didn't stop until we reached the Ket Du wilderness. They left me there alone, without a copper, in a torn lace dress, right when the frosts were setting in. They assumed something would eat me, or that I'd do everyone a favor and die of hunger. But as always, I failed to live up to expectations. I wandered the woods for a week, went purple from the cold, gnawed the bark from twigs. Finally, I saw a light among the trees. A campsite. They were bandits, bearded, drunk, spattered with blood. I was sure they'd rape me or kill me, or both.
Take it neither happened?
That's when I learned a robber and a murderer can be a better man than a knight in shining armor. They took me in, we set off for Nazaire, and I did what I could to repay them. I advanced in their ranks rather quickly, and eventually I became their leader of the whole ragged band.
Should have stayed there, maybe.
Perhaps. Perhaps I should have forgotten everything, started a new life. But you know what? There came a point when I thought, you wanted a monster. Then a monster you shall get.
Been through a lot.
I have. And throughout this time, my sister was stomping grapes and shagging minstrels on down bedding.
She wasn't the one to banish you.
And I'm not angry at her for that. I'm angry at her because she forgot about me. Right. We've had our chat. Come.
Damn, you're ugly.
This is the spot. Pull out the beans.
Oh boy.
Repair your sword.
I don't have any repair kits left, so I can't. Man, this life-absorbing thing almost makes it easy. Almost too easy.
Should have stocked.
Wait.
Why?
The stalk will sprout abruptly. Very abruptly. We must be careful. All right, toss them.
Something's always gotta go wrong.
Saw that one coming.
The home stretch.
Neat. Now we're gonna go to whatever the fuck the Sky City was called in Bioshock Infinite. I forget.
The stalk just required some comedic timing to it. Columbia.
Oh yeah.
Incredible.
That's what it was. Wait, Kaer Morhen?
Admire the view later. First, we must deal with... him.
Oh. Fuck yeah. Now we're Dark Souls. What the fuck?
Is this Dark Souls?
It is now. And I'm almost dead.
Not delay. Sea fight over. I smell a giant bug.
Or is it just decoration?
giant is wearing an awful lot of metal.
Yeah, but it doesn't seem like I can get him to actually punch this stuff. Also, Garrett was smashed.
A stronger opponent than a player.
G-N-I.
Why? What would that be useful for? What does... Well, I don't know. Well, I already died again. Oh, now it hit him. Okay.
Put him on fire.
He had to do the swirly thing near it. That was supposed to trick.
That was one tough son of a wench.
Anyway.
I told you this land had gone ape mad, though I did not
expect
now
I get it. He dives under the cloud so the lightning won't hit him.
Why ever would I have?
To get rid of your guard, your captor. Getting close to the exit at this point. Probably think you don't need me anymore.
Well, you're wrong. You still stand to be quite useful to me.
Yeah, I know. Gotta get you out of here. Come on.
Wait, that's not what I meant.
I think.
I need you for something far simpler and far more pleasant.
No. Abort, 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 stop. No, abort. Stop it.
No.
Bad juju. Bad touch. Bad touch.
Another time, another place, maybe. No offense.
None taken. You spoke clearly, you spoke honestly. It's fine.
This happened way too quick.
Killing that Come. Giant really the make her horny. Made.
I liked it better when he had it misspelled because it made it sound somewhat like almost tribal. That made it better.
Willow the Wisp. I think it's got something to show us.
Careful. It's not to be trusted.
Yeah. What's up, dude? Nothing.
Just curious. Why do you want the Heart of Toussaint and the Ducal Wine?
They were my right, my due.
Doubt we would have figured you out if you hadn't tried to get them. Know that, don't you?
I do. I regret nothing. One lives but once. Here, we need but jump into the well.
Jump after the Wisp.
You sure this is what we need to do? Nice. Now that's...
Cyan is all for YOLO.
I was gonna make a YOLO comment, but I didn't.
Portals in a fountain? Not terribly practical.
It was a secret passage. Anariette and I would use it to...
hide from your governess. Which luckily she noted down in her diary, thus I knew where to await you.
Nice, pal.
Never mind that. Has the young lady agreed to help clean up the mess she's made?
She has. And stop treating me as if I were a child.
Well,
would
comparatively.
Would you prefer I treated you like the lying manipulator you are?
Stop it, you guys.
But
no buts.
Your humor is not as cheap as mine.
Let's go. Really want to be done with this.
Geralt is so fed up.
Geralt and Regis are brothers for life.
Nice place,
isn't it? Offers a lovely view of the valley. On a clear day, you can see the outlines of Dun Tyne.
Is it, though? A ruin like any other, I think.
So sensitive. So aware. Honestly, what did Detlef ever see in you?
Perhaps he'll tell you himself.
Let's get ready. Detlef will be here any moment now.
A woman who doesn't appreciate ruins is a bad pick.
Ruins are pretty cool. Though they're usually also associated with delinquents, mostly because, you know, you usually can't enter without reaching some kind of thing.
Simple.
Oh no, it's very simple. You either deceived me or not. In forgiving you, I grieve. For now, we must part.
What?
But how?
What? Huh? What the fuck?
The ribbon. Ha! Seems I've been fooled again. She will pay for this sooner or later.
Her ribbon
she
saved
will
her.
Pay. You never should have meddled, Butcher.
Oh shit.
Thank you.
Oh fuck, it's just like one of my Japanese animes.
Detlaf's fucking pissed.
Oh god. Oh shit, do I need to do anything? Oh no. Oh no.
I want you, Jetpack! You traitor! Don't come here!
Didn't plan any of it.
Silence!
Use traps.
Nah. I just want to quench. Whoa! What? Jesus! What the fuck?
Eat some of it, darling.
Oh my god!
Use holy water and cross boomerang.
If you acknowledge any gods, start praying now!
Oh... fuck! Oh my god! No, stop! Oh! Yeah, fucking stop! No! Oh my god.
Now that's a nice vampire.
Oh shit. No! Well.
That vampire is not a sparkle.
Jesus. Sweet Jesus. Stop.
Are your additional life bars gonna save you?
Probably, yeah. Well, there goes another one. I really don't know how many of these I have. Ah, shit. Ah, there I go. Christ almighty. Whew, what a fight. Alright. I gotta actually get in here and do something.
Not busy.
Is it? Perhaps.
The ribbon.
Do you think shooting him could work?
Hold on a sec. I have things to level up. This would actually be super useful. So, what else do I have? Strong attack. I don't use strong attacks. Ah, jeez. Nice. Very nice. What else do I have? Sure, let's just put everything in this. Next thing.
I want you just for this.
You tricked me.
Both of you. Didn't plan any of it. Silence.
Sure wish I had some fucking stuff to actually heal me, you know. Nope. Yes, shooting him probably would help, but I'm so bad at aiming. Ah, jeez.
Acknowledge any gods. Start playing now.
No, he doesn't. It doesn't help. He deflects it. Oh shit. Fucking hell. Ah, fuck. Okay. Kinda got the timing for the second kind of dodge. Okay. so little damage. Oh my god. Petra's gonna be a third form as well. Ah, shit! Oh my god, I'm fucking up so much. What's going on? Are you fucking kidding me?
You think that will stop me? Prepare to die, Witcher!
Oh no, 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 no.
Strike the heart. Make sure not to die.
I'm trying so hard.
You can do it. Well done.
Holy shit.
Good work, man.
That was one hell of a fight. Not in terms of difficulty, but in terms of spectacle. Holy shit.
That was thrilling.
Leave him to me. Be gone.
I can't let...
I insist.
Thank you.
Delicious.
The new vampire, Exodrake, revitalize yourself immediately. Only at Best Buy.
My, what a smashing ensemble. You wear it well.
Shut up.
Gusting.
Look like a twit.
Yes. The caftan is sewn of the best fabrics available, and according to the best tailoring practices. But one must have a modicum of taste to appreciate this. Even the most exquisite robes cover only deficiencies in beauty, never in refinement.
Rather not bicker about taste. Don't like to. It's neither interesting nor productive.
This particular Witcher has an inborn intolerance for formal occasions, yet he's to attend just such an event shortly. I expect that's the source of his prickliness. So try not to take things personally, Master Taylor. Rather pity him, for in truth, stage fright overwhelms him. He trembles at the thought that he has no notion how to behave in the presence of Her Grace's Majesty.
As well he should.
Nope, not at all.
All that being as it may, Toussaint's highest honor, the Order of Vitis Vinifera, demands appropriate attire. The
so
Duchess
dumb.
Cannot be expected to drape the medal on a suit of armor caked in mud. Palace protocol places enormous emphasis on form, virtuous tradition, etiquette.
Huh, a tradition which values appearances ahead of all else, which calls for lordly, glistening triviality and misplaced generosity.
Sound wistful. Pensive, Regis. That because they refuse to buy you a new outfit?
Hardly. It's the tone I ever adopt when I find myself pondering, which, believe it or not, happens quite a lot. Besides, I've no need for a new outfit as I shall not be attending the ceremony.
Why not?
Because unlike you, I don't have to. I shall be going to pack my belongings instead. I trust you'll join me later, once you're richer by a medal and a fascinating new experience.
Count on it. Ceremonies, medals honoring virtues, just keeps coming up.
He looks so dumb.
I've had no reprieve either. And I keep thinking of the last great virtue, compassion. It's the one piece of the puzzle that never seemed to fit.
Mean you suddenly believe the five virtues theory, after all we've revealed?
It's not a question of belief, superstition, or old wives' tales. It's a conclusion derived through exercising pure logic. Siana planned everything in advance. Had we not stopped her, surely there'd have been a fifth victim. One the gossips would have associated with a lack of compassion.
Her plans don't matter now. Can't act on them. Ask the messenger who delivered my invitation to the ceremony. Siana's in the palace. Courtiers pressured the Duchess to lock her in a tower.
Do you care not a whit who else was in her black book? We've some time before the ceremony. We could still chat with that boot-clean urchin. He was the one to pass the victim's names to Detlaf. Perhaps we missed something.
Regis, Bootblack didn't say anything about making deliveries when we talked to him. How do you know he handled the letters?
While you basked in glory and tried on new formal wear, I conducted a little investigation of my own. You'd be very proud to see how I conducted myself. I began by concocting an ample supply of boot wash for our enterprising young friend. I'd observed that among street folk, amidst their society as a whole, reciprocity takes precedence over all other codes, and thus no good deed goes unrewarded. Of course, the same holds true for malicious or destructive deeds.
The letters. What's the connection?
When the bootblack arrived to collect his bucketful, he hinted he knew more. Simply put, we'd failed to ask the proper questions when we chatted earlier. It took a bit more tongue-loosening, but ultimately he spoke. He admitted he'd handed Detlaf the letters. He knew this information was valuable to me. In providing it, he was simply repaying me.
Sure. Let's go.
All in all, why not check up on that? We'll go together, assuming we're done here.
I am done, yes. It lies in your hands now to see if you are able to present my handiwork at the ceremony with the dignity it is due.
Nope.
Or if you will first destroy it, crawling about the city's underbelly.
Yes.
Promise to be careful.
Nope. If I can, I'm even going to put on other clothes. Just to spite you.
Oh, it's the swordsman. Good to see you. Here for a spiffing? Dirty boots are a stain on professional dignity, you know. Step on up.
Need to ask you something.
Yet again? Go on then. I'm a proponent of free speech and I will gladly tell you all I know. But why not get your boots shanked while we jabber?
Guess they could use a spit and polish.
Then I shall take
Geralt
advantage
is gonna
as well.
Jump on roofs
a
and dirty
of mine
it.
Used to say boots should be as clean as the soles that wear them.
Clean boots, clean soles. A fine slogan.
Man in the frock coat. You passed him some letters, remember?
Why, of course. I'm young, got a mind like a steel trap, but...
If you're about to tell me this information will cost me, forget it. How'd you get those letters?
Beggars brought them.
Beggars. Tell us more about them. How many were there?
Why, four. One for each letter.
Just four? Sure you didn't get a fifth?
I can't count, you know.
Remember anything else? These beggars have anything in common?
What? Come now. Each was different. Some had mismatched boots, others had no boots at all.
Oh, I know. They all had no home.
Kid, my patience is starting to run a little thin. Now think hard. Remember what they looked like?
Of course. I've a mind like a steel trap, as I said. They were ragged, unshaved. Their clothes were tattered. As to their boots, well, I mentioned that already.
Geralt, allow me to ask a question. Listen, lad. I'll be glad to mix another batch of that boot shine for you. But you must focus now and tell us all you know. Where can we find the beggars?
Well, at the shelter, most like.
Where's that?
Everyone knows. It's just round the corner. Up those stairs, then right.
Thanks, kid. For your trouble. We must visit the shelter. Look around inside.
Ah, much better. Now I look like a gimp again.
You've to move your little camp elsewhere, got it? This is a decent distance.
You? What do you want?
To talk.
Here, that's a waste of breath. We've tried it, only to tire our lips. We'll use other means of persuasion now.
Gentlemen, calm, please.
Either get out along with these flea-ridden vagabonds, or we'll toss you all out. Our patience is gone. This place is no longer a rank refuse dump.
Scram! Decent folk live here.
The shelter, them living here, bothers you. Question is why?
Look, Ballard. Another defender of the poor, fighter for justice.
Damn nuisance. We for our women and young folk living next door.
Oh, when it's those guys who visited the kid earlier.
Such rabble.
Decent folk you mention. Mean yourselves.
Why? Do you doubt it?
Hell yes.
Hear that, Artois? He poking insults us. On our own turf.
We should step aside, good fellow.
My friend is perfectly capable of settling this unfortunate dispute on his own.
Fisticuffs! Yes! Ground this. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Well, they've wisened up a bit, since last time at least. Whoa, dude.
I'll break your guts around your spine.
Booster cuffing again.
Mm-hmm. Whoa, whoa, whoa. That dude just jumped. I can't parry in this mode, apparently. At least I... Oh, I can. Okay, never mind. I can. I just wasn't doing it right.
All right.
What?
I could take a hint. Come, time to go.
I thank you so much for your aid. I tried to reason with them, but they'd have beat me blue had you not come along. I'm grateful. Immensely.
What did they want from you?
They are neighbors. Wish me to take my folk, the shelter, elsewhere. They dislike that I help the Beckers. I do not oppose going elsewhere, were we to have somewhere to go. But you've come with a problem, have you? My turn to aid you.
Need some information. Looking for a man who might have mentioned the Boot Black in Rue de Garl.
The Boot Black? A feisty lad. I know him.
Any of your wards supposed to meet him recently or soon?
Forgive me. Those I help and I are not so close that I would know. But should you wait, they'll all soon come for their meal. You can question them yourselves.
Thanks. We'll wait. Nice of you to let us.
Nice of you to let us? Are they gonna eat salad? Oh my god, chat crashed. Whoops. Hold on a sec. Things. There we go. First time that's happened during a stream.
My dears, I've a matter to address before I serve the soup. These two gentlemen have some questions of you. Pay attention. Answer in brief. For if you draw it out, your soup will go cold, and we wouldn't want that, would we?
Recently, four of you delivered sealed letters to the Boot Black. I know this.
Does anyone know what the gentleman means? Go on, speak up. Romain?
Why should I squeak? You were all told not to mention the letters. We all swore.
You can tell me, Romain. Given a letter and you delivered it, right? Good work, Romain. Thank you. Who else?
I got the one too. Gave it to the Boot Black. Freshie, he got one. But he can't tell you, as he's not here.
I still have mine. I'm to deliver it 2 days after the Feast of St. Barnabas.
It's a matter of importance to the duchy. Hand it over, or I'll take it from you, plain and simple.
But I was to deliver it personally. Let no one else see it. That is what she said, and she was frightening.
You ought to heed folk who are kind and honest. These men helped me a short while ago, helped all of us. If this individual threatened you, you need not keep the promise you made.
All right, take it. I didn't want to see the Boot Black anyways. It's always muddy there.
Damn it. What is it? Another name, truly?
See for yourself.
Well, I must say, even I did not expect this. This time, I will see to Arjukasa. It seems we underestimated Siana rather grossly.
Yep, saw that one coming.
Judging by this, Detloff was literally supposed to tear her heart out.
Yet first you must snap her neck. Puzzling.
Puzzle complete now.
Alas, the matter ceased to be a tantalizing brain tease and has turned incredibly grave. We've proof of a plot to assassinate Toussaint's ruler. We've proof of a coup d'etat.
Duchess was to be Detloff's last victim. Siana planned it from the start.
Mm-hmm. Indeed. The logical conclusion, Geralt.
Four seemingly random victims to start. The virtue's their only link. Enough to get folk talking about a righteous, vengeful beast. Obscured the victim's links to Siana, even as she had those she despised killed off one by one, leaving the Duchess for last.
Had she managed to fulfill her plan, none would have questioned the reasons. Most would have thought Anna Henrietta had died for her sins. She was known to show a hard heart on many occasions. Ample proof of a lack of compassion.
Why would Siana murder her own sister? Out of envy? To take power? From an inborn penchant for evil?
Yes, yes, and yes. All seem likely, and none are mutually exclusive. But if you'd like to know for certain, you could always ask her yourself.
Actually, love to learn her motives.
Praiseworthy, I suppose. Sometimes one should stare evil in the face.
Seems a bit strong, no?
She used my friend as her tool for killing. I believe I've every right to condemn her, but I support your lust for the truth. Some philosophers think empirical examination the sole path to knowledge. I believe you mentioned the Duchess keeps Siana locked up.
Courtiers were insisting on a harsher punishment. Much harsher. Think Anna Henrietta had to protect her sister from a lynch mob as much as she wanted to protect her subjects from a criminal. One way or another, she's locked away in a secluded wing of the palace, awaiting trial before a court of law. I'd need to get past some guards to see her. Coming with?
Of course not. I shall await you at Mare La Chaise Longue. I'll not risk entering the palace after Detloff and his minions' rampage. Besides, I vastly prefer the company of a simple mug of mandrake brew to that of the Duchess's vile sister.
So, said straight up, it means you're going off to get drunk because you hate Siana.
I've never been fond of categorical statements of that kind, but I admit I could not vouch for my behavior in her presence.
She treated Detloff cruelly.
Caused his death in the end, and now this? Atop all that? No, Geralt. I will not go with you. I will await you at the cemetery.
All right, let's finish this, shall we?
Bloody hell.
Bloody hell indeed. Doesn't seem to be the way. Maybe it is. I don't know.
Oh God, the spout is way.
The guard brings peace to our domains. Flout its writ and rot its chain.
That's gonna work.
Oh!
Ah!
Seems it's not over yet.
Lepiotus wheezing lungs.
Ah!
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 Anyone making trouble during the festival will be severely punished.
This mist flows in the veins, Doctor.
Nice little sprint in the night. Keeps Geralt fit, you know. Otherwise he'd grow a belly. Kinda have that.
Sienna, urgently.
In the matter of?
It's really late. How much longer will you be streaming?
Shame we didn't see any trolls in this expansion.
Oh boy. Yes, it is late.
Want to talk to her? It's important.
Want to talk? Go see your gran at tea time. Not one locked up on the Duchess's orders. No doing without special permission. Period.
Found some information important to her case. Need an explanation. Urgently.
Ah, fine then. You're that witcher who solved the murders, no? Then you've my permission, but only for a few minutes.
Promise to be brief.
Didn't wanna accidentally fuffer her. And yes, shame that there weren't any trolls.
The witcher will speak with the inmate. You can take a momentary break.
As long as it's truly but a moment. Highly irregular, this.
Have you come to see how I fare? I'm fine, thank you. Artorias's ribbon worked wonders. It's a shame they took it from me.
I know who the fifth victim was supposed to be.
Goodness, you're simply a compulsive snoop. I'm in prison. Dedlof is dead. Could you not just drop it?
Sienna, stop pretending you couldn't care less. I know it's an act, and it's really starting to wear. Why do you want to kill her?
For such an accomplished investigator to ask about the obvious? Come now, Geralt. Why do you think?
Because she turned her back on you? Then banished all memory of you.
Bravo, Geralt. Yet another riddle solved, and your sick curiosity sated. Well, what now? Off to share your discovery with Anna Henrietta. Oh, she's no longer in danger, true. But she very well might add a little something to your reward.
Definitely gonna tell her. Not necessarily for the coin, though.
Then why do it at all?
She ought to know. If only because you'll probably try to kill her again if she ever lets you out.
I probably will.
At least you're being honest, finally.
Lying only ever makes sense when there's a chance someone will believe you. It's actually refreshing, in a way, to say what I truly think. So why don't I do it a bit more? I was only ever nice to you to get you to sleep with me. I thought you might come in handy one day.
Of course.
Your comrade Regis is using you, and Anna Henrietta perceives you solely as her unthinking, blunt instrument. She's right to, you know.
Enjoy hurting people? That it? Sorry, but won't give you the satisfaction. The Witcher mutations, you know. It's hard to draw my blood.
Don't worry. I'll find a way.
Have a nice life, Sienna.
Regis is using Geralt. Oh no.
Well, that's what she thinks. not necessarily what's going on.
Commander de la Tour would like to see you. Shall we go at once?
Sure.
Let's go. Want to see him too.
Damien.
Geralt, it's about time. Ready for the ceremony?
Got some important information. Anna Henrietta was supposed to be Detlaff and Sianna's fifth victim.
You are certain of this?
Completely. Found proof.
Inconceivable. How could she? The murders, the mayhem she brought down on the city, were they not enough? She sought to strike down her own sister, her liege. Traitor. I must alert my men. Enlarge the Duchess's honor guard. Make certain Sylvia Anna is closely watched during the questioning. I'll see to it personally. I thank you, Witcher, for alerting me, and I appreciate your attentiveness. Very well. Let us get things underway. Don your ceremonial.
No!
Then you'll come with me. Her grace awaits.
I don't want to don this thing. Fuck. Look like it, right twat. And that.
Damien is a nice dude.
In the guild's name, I beg your assistance, your enlightened highness. Without barrels, production will come to a stop, and it will be the end of us.
You lost them all in the fire. These are horrible tidings. Oh, we are most dreadfully saddened.
Yes, your enlightened highness all. Once the beasts had clawed their way into the warehouse, the whole place went up in flames.
I shall dispatch a palace guardsman to examine the site of the blaze. If things are, as you say, fitting compensation shall be paid from the ducal treasury.
Thank you, your enlightened highness. Your grace, Geralt of Rivia has arrived.
My dear subjects, we come now to our next point of business. Of all the duties which fall upon my shoulders, as the ruler of this dominion, this duty is dearest to my heart. For now, we shall award the Order of Vitis Vinifera, Tucson's highest honor.
Geralt of Rivia, Slayer of the Beast of Beauclair, step forth.
We bestow the distinction upon the Witcher, who saved Beauclair from the terrible beast. Such is our desire.
Will Geralt get a new sword?
May the symbol serve as a reminder to all that the Witcher shall forever remain a friend of Beauclair. In more familiar terms now, I thank you immensely, Geralt. Damien has your reward for you. After all, it was but a contract.
Thank you.
I have a small surprise for you, in addition. I give you more than a dozen barrels of Sonreal, a wine normally reserved for the ducal table. The gustatory experience of a lifetime awaits. Are you content?
Oh, that third answer. Holy shit. This is the perfect time. Oh, I want to do this.
BB is gonna be happy.
This is... It's so wrong, but I so want... Fuck it.
I am, and truly grateful, Your Grace. Sadly, I'm afraid I have to sour the mood. It's Sianna, She plotted to have you killed, Duchess. Planned to use Detlaff. You were to be the Beast's fifth victim.
This cannot be true. You're mistaken. You must be.
I have proof.
I was hoping he would be more blunt, but this is fine.
I do not believe it. In a moment, I shall speak to Sianna. Will you assist me?
You returned my sister to me, yet what you tell me now, I find devastating. I've come to doubt that I can judge her fairly. I'd far prefer to learn you're mistaken, Geralt.
I'm not. In fact, I'd recommend you be particularly careful around her.
You exaggerate, Witcher. She is my sister. I know well how to speak to her.
Do you really?
If my presence will help in any manner, of course I'll stay.
We shall now question a person implicated in the murders which recently ravaged our fair city of Beauclair. Captain de la Tour, show Silvia Anna in.
What do you mean, in? It's outside. Time to fetch it.
The Witcher will take part in our talk.
I'm not a prisoner. Free to do as I choose.
Bitch.
You have committed crimes. Grave.
Well,
crimes.
They still bring her in, even if it's
you
outside.
Are my sister, and my heart does not allow me to treat you as a common criminal. Nor does it let me believe you sought my demise. My heart yearns to know you were swayed by the monster Detlaff. You yourself would never stoop so low. Thus, I have asked Geralt to advise me, as one impartial. I shall now hear what he has to say.
I don't understand what the second choice means. Punish, like, not any criminal? So, what does that mean exactly? Does that mean they're gonna, like, make some magics happen so that she lives out an infinite amount of pain or something? I don't understand.
Blood doesn't matter, hang her.
Yeah, I mean, this is really a confusing choice. Like, should she be... Does the first one imply that her being royal doesn't matter, or does the second one imply that? I'm so confused. Whatever.
No matter the mitigating circumstances, whatever they may be, Sianna is a criminal and should be tried as such. And punished as such. Her guilt is clear.
Your words sadden me greatly, Witcher. But I cannot deny their logic. Sianna, you shall
maybe
be tried.
Maybe the second option means that Henrietta's decision is the most important one.
We shall never cease to be family. As Duchess, I shall have to judge you.
But as your sister, I shall never stop loving you.
No.
Will you forgive me? I shall never forgive you.
Saw that one coming. Well. What a fucking dumbass.
Good job.
GG. GG easy.
Very Shakespeare-esque.
Shaky cam. Alright. So, is Geralt gonna be the new king? Queen? Make Regis the king. It's gonna be a vampire city.
Need some flowers. A wreath, or...
I've none. Sold everything. I was just on my way out. No sense hanging about with nothing to do.
What the fuck's up with
Everyone's
your neck,
dead, Geralt.
Should come as no shock, sir. Had the funeral. Folk took it all. Men, women, children. Always to lay a bouquet on the Duchess's grave.
Damien's gonna be the Duke of Wine now.
Peonies, gladioli. But she liked common roses best. I know.
Ripping pepperoni, by the way.
I'd choose the loveliest blooms for her. Fragrant, big petals, the kind that last a long time.
She looked very Italian, is all I can say about her.
I've still not come to terms with it. To be killed by her own sister? How could it happen?
Also, is this a bad ending or something?
Anna Henrietta wanted to believe there was still hope for Sienna, that she'd show remorse. She reached a hand out to her. Too soon. Too trusting.
Oh, I know you. You're that witcher from the north. The one that saved us from the beast.
Could say that.
Wait here. Take these.
Thought you were out of flowers.
I put a bouquet aside. I was to take it to her myself. But you have it. I know you held the Duchess dear.
How much do I owe you?
Not a copper.
She was a fool.
Keep your coin and raise a toast in her memory.
Silly dilly.
Do just that. Farewell.
They made that statue fucking quick.
She would get killed anyway.
Okay, so there's no choice. Alright, cool.
With the exquisite hair.
That witch is rather handsome.
What? Which lady was this? Lady. Hi.
Hey there.
Yeah, hi.
I'm about to fall asleep, so I'll watch the rest of this tomorrow. Good night, loves. Have a good funeral.
I don't know if there's no choice.
Okay. Good night, Gingy. Look it up, bro, if there's no choice.
Fuck.
Witcher, I was certain you'd departed.
Couldn't. Anna Henrietta was...
wondrous. Beautiful. Good. The best ruler one could hope to have. yet I let her down.
Don't be so hard on yourself. No one expected Siana to do that, persist to the end.
But I think she would get murdered eventually anyway.
Because there was nothing we could do.
I suppose you are right. But when someone so beloved dies, one cannot help but search one's soul
anyway,
for blame.
Anyway, Siana had a fucking pro
and
stab
the
there.
Knights grow faint-hearted.
Killed her instantly.
Come to pay my
pretty
respects.
Good.
Did the Duchess
pretty
farewell.
Good.
White roses. They were her favorite. Go inside, then. She lies in the ducal crypt. In one room with her murderer. Despite my protests.
What? Who decided that?
The Regent's Council. A pack of old men who've statutes and codices for hearts. Ducal blood flowed in Siana's veins, and she was never legally disinherited. So they ruled she should lie alongside Anarieta.
Whatever. I would have placed no flowers.
I regret it ended this way, that I failed to prevent it. Hope you can forgive me. Rest in peace.
Oh, hey. Hi, dude. What's up?
Stylish crypt, quite subdued. Yes, this is the kind of eternal resting place I dream of.
Moments like this, I never know if you're joking or serious.
Serious, Geralt, serious. It's remarkably peaceful, subtly charming to the hilt. A perfect match for the Duchess's dignity.
Oh, she could forgive her if you picked some
you
different
humans,
choices.
You never cease to amaze me. To feel despair in the face of natural processes to which you are predestined. I've
thought
come to take you from this place, my friend. Dare say you deserve a speck of respite after the mad whirl of the last few days.
Anyway, I'm cool with this.
All those deaths I failed to prevent. Feel pretty awful right about now. Can't help thinking I could have done more. Now Toussaint's left without a ruler. Or more accurately, chaos rules here.
At least Geralt is still a good guy in their eyes.
Duchess won over people's hearts. All Beauclair now weeps for her.
A mass outburst of emotion. Well, it seems her subjects have adopted some of their recent ruler's traits.
Why the sarcasm? Thought you liked Anna Henrietta.
I did. And I do truly rue her passing.
Me too.
And that laugh didn't kill her.
Mm-hmm. It seems like there's actually a good couple of different endings you could get here.
Whatever you say about Siona, you gotta admit, she was unbending.
That she was. I do admit it. Though, in her case, it would have been better if she had been a tad more philosophical, pausing from time to time to reflect on the propriety of her actions.
True.
How do you find my personal brew? Not too strong.
Just right.
Credit the local mandrake of the Alrauna Diavolus variety for that. The tubers which grow in this area's volcanic soil have an altogether unique flavor profile and display a remarkably uncommon dark brown tint.
Fascinating. All I can say is this batch turned out excellent.
Indeed. It might be wise to stockpile some roots for the future. Would you care to accompany me?
If you think it's a good idea, let's go. But I think you might be forgetting one thing. Fresh mandrake root of this variety is highly toxic, even to a witcher.
Ah, not a problem. I never forget matters of safety and hygiene in alchemy. Here, gloves and a mask. Don them, and you shall be in no danger.
Thanks. Right then, let's go.
This moonlight makes...
Do I really need to do this? Sounds dumb. Oh wait, I don't actually see them anywhere here. Weird. Okay, I guess it's contextual.
Oh, so dreamy.
Penny for your thoughts. Let me guess. Succubus twins?
No, I was thinking about... Oh, how anything can look interesting when properly lit.
Even an old necrophage corpse?
You've not an ounce of refinement in you, have you?
I love you, Geralt. You're a good baby boy. What I need to pick? Hardcore. Bollocks. Oh, still did. This is so. I love cheating.
Now, where'd that bloodsucker go? Won't be easy to track down. He's a vampire, after all.
Regis!
Damn it, where'd you go?
Regis!
You raise your hand against the vampire! You shall die for that!
I did what I had to do!
Okay, well...
Those Bruxay, they called you a traitor.
Alas, we've a very simple code of honor, we vampires. So simple you might call it trivial. Either one is with us, unconditionally, regardless of the circumstances, or...
Won't let it go, will they?
They will not. Fortunately, we've another rule, an unwritten one, and just as trivial as the first. It is neatly summarized in the saying, out of sight, out of mind. That is why I must leave Toussaint. For a vastly long time, most like.
Yeah, I get it.
Let us make for my camp. I've an overwhelming desire to have another drink. Soup. Supreme bouquet. Firm, defined beginning. Then develops gently, rising to a startling finish. Don't you think?
Not much of a connoisseur.
Then it is high time you started your education. After all, the Corvo Bianco vineyard is now yours. By the way, I left a gift for you at your new home. On the nightstand.
Thanks. Mind telling me what it is?
A trifle. That will nonetheless be useful should you need mutagens. Incidentally, have you thought about what you'll do with your prize?
Shall you hang your swords over the mantle and take to pruning vines?
Don't know yet.
Don't really know yet. Might find the life of a hard-working vintner too tempting one day. Or maybe I'll just stick to the path, go on roaming, staring up at the stars after laying my bedroll at the roadside.
Ah, roadsides, bedrolls, and the sky above. I sense some poetry coming on, which of course brings to mind Dandelion. I can remember a night, not too far from here if I'm not mistaken. We hid in a cave while a blizzard raged all about. Does that sound at all familiar?
How could it not? We just set off to rescue Ciri from Vilgefortz.
Oh, our encounter with Vilgefortz. That is something I do not remember so fondly. But that first stay in Beauclair, far calmer than this one.
Seemed like a land straight out of a fairy tale back then. Its sole problem, cellars too small to accommodate all that wine.
Appearances, Geralt. Appearances like Mamoons and Dopplers deceive. So what did become of Vilgefortz?
Killed him. Sure wasn't easy, though. What about you? Any idea where you'll go?
Distance is of the essence. I thought I might venture south.
Nilfgaard?
Why ever not? The Nilfgaardians are a modern society. None there believe in vampires anymore. This fact alone could be very useful to one wishing to remain incognito.
Interesting point of view. I so don't feel like going anywhere. Sit here a while longer?
So we shall, my friend. We have witnessed, and in fact on several occasions incited, many great and weighty events. After all that toil, I believe we deserve a bit of a rest.
That we do.
That we do indeed. Well, there was blood and wine. Pretty good. Pretty good. Good stuff. Good shit. But I think I kind of enjoyed Hearts and Stone a bit better. At least from a story and character kind of point of view. The whole stuff around Gontor, them, and what's his face? The other dude. Was a lot more intriguing than all this noble stuff here that was going on. Though, naturally, the all the landscapes and vistas in this region are still absolutely breathtaking, and some of the best in the game by far.
Olgierd.
Yes, Olgierd. I don't know if I like Skellige better or this place. They're both very, very nice places. So yeah, we're done with Witcher. For real now. Barring some occasional just stabbling into the game for funsies and smashing about. It might become a sort of a game kind of similar to Burnout, where I just do a thing because I'm bored or because I don't feel like doing anything else, so we can just roam around and take in the scenery and beat up some guys every now and again, maybe do some quests. But as a series, as a full-time series, Witcher is now fully over. Because there won't be any more content for it either. CD Projekt Red is working on different things now. And yeah. I had a good time. A really good time, fabulous time.
Witcher 3 is a very nice game, worthy of the praise it gets.
Oh yes, definitely. Very,
It's truly astounding how well made it is. Like, the amount of voice acting and effort and animation and everything they put into it is just really, really blows everything else out of the water. The sheer amount of content they have in here and the high quality that everything is. Like, even the most menial kind of quests, side quests that you have, fetch quests or whatever, have a character that actually talks to you.
The writers have done a great job.
Yeah, and has dialogue and everything, so it's immensely fleshed out. Yeah, and
everyone else as well.
Yeah, most everything is really surprisingly well written. Like, these are some of the most memorable and impressionable characters I've seen in a video game so far. Like, really well characterized and written in a way that they actually really do feel distinct, like their own kinds of personalities and own characters, and not just a different shade of the same thing, same color, I guess. So yeah, this was really good. Really, really, really good. Yeah, I'm kind of, as last time when we finished The Witcher 3 proper and Hearts of Stone, I'm kind of sad to see you go. But yeah, we'll probably return to it occasionally, as I mentioned. So look forward to that, and I guess in the meantime, other things. We're gonna finish Transistor next, and then we're gonna start up Trails of Cold Steel as a sort of regular hourly thing, similar to Rune Factory, and we're also gonna start on the Hotel Dusk sequel, which is looking fairly good from 5 minutes I've played of it. Yeah, sounding good. Good things ahead. What else do we have on the schedule, actually? A lot of things I want to play. But, yeah, I guess I'll see what most piques my curiosity next. Yeah, alright. Don't really have much else to say. But, I don't know. Anything in particular you would like to see? There's a few games that I really want to see, but can't recall the names right now because I'm terrible at that. And I can't look on the list because I can't scroll in my browser right now.
I'm gonna wait for Fire Emblem and Dark Souls after you finish playing the games you mentioned before.
Oh god, Fire Emblem. Fuck. You cruel, cruel bastard. You really want to see me suffer, don't you?
And looking forward to seeing Kyle Hyde.
Yes. Can't wait to see Kyle Hyde smirk again.
Thank you.
Phew, that's a lot of people, right? So, now that we've been properly introduced, we'd like to thank you one last time. Blood and Wine is the end of Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. We wanted to call it Sweat and Tears, or damn, we'll miss this, but we couldn't. However, I couldn't read the rest of the text either, because it blended away too quickly. Why do they keep on doing this? I will never know.
Actually, I'd love to go home.
Fine. We'll do one last thing. Where's the next quick travel point? There it is. Just this about. Get out of my way.
I'm gonna look at the shoe trolls after this.
Don't diddly! My Camelec ate something!
Master Witcher, some unknown individual barged into the residence. I resisted as best I could, but to no avail.
Who is it?
Alas, they did not do me the basic courtesy of introducing themselves.
Wow, BB, you gotta learn your martial arts, bro.
What's that smell?
Whoa, what? Siri? Good.
Calm. Don't just stand there. I want a hug.
What did you bring?
A Garkin from Angryn. I slew it.
Nice.
All by my lonesome.
That why you left Carrera so suddenly? Had no idea where you'd gone. Your note was puzzling. Don't try to find me. Threw me for a loop.
That was silly. It's just that I felt stifled in your shadow. I'd have suffocated had I stayed. So when I read that notice, the contract. When I saw Angryn, I knew I had to do it. Alone,
a nice visit from daughter.
Without my nanny.
I'm not your nanny. I believe in you. Like my new house?
The house is lovely. But it could use a bit of work.
Yeah. Got plans for it, don't worry. Wanna go outside? Could show you the grounds.
This is nice.
Ah, oh, it's lovely here. I could stay forever.
What's stopping you?
Actually, not a thing. I slew a Garkin, collected my bounty. I believe I'm owed some respite.
Indeed you do, mademoiselle, as my majordomo would say.
You've a butler?
A steward. Name's Barnabas Basil. BB for short, though I don't know if he likes it. He's the one let you in. I'll ask him to bring in some fruit, a beverage. You can spend the rest of the day lying about.
Ah, nothing would make me happier.
Angryn, how'd it go? Garkanes can be pretty tough opponents.
That's why I had to lure this one to a place both spacious and empty, where it would have nowhere to hide. I found an abandoned crypt far from any town or village.
Good choice. Always best to avoid additional casualties, so your foe had nowhere to hide. But the bastard was still damn quick, I bet.
Not as quick as I am. My greater worry was its strength. I was far outclassed there. But a dose of black blood did the trick.
We fought a while. I feigned a mistimed dodge and let it drink. The rest was easy.
He's so proud.
Encountered the most charming aspect of being a Witcher yet?
Which aspect is that?
The hatred, disgust, that strange blend of admiration, fear, and contempt.
They set their hounds on me in one village. In another, they forbade me from taking a drink from their well. Other than that, it's been all right. No one's tried to cheat me out of my reward so far.
I'd hoped they'd treat a woman differently.
Geralt, when they treat a woman differently in this world, it hardly ever means better. Quite the opposite.
Being a Witcher anything like you imagined?
Geralt, I didn't have to imagine anything. Remember, before we parted, we walked a good stretch of the path together.
Journeyman and master, though, not the same thing.
I'm still a long way from mastering anything, but I am trying. Anyway, I did learn from the best.
Just passed on what worked for me, or at least tried to.
I was thinking of Eskel and Lambert.
So, no regrets? Choice you made?
Not at all. I'm doing what I ever wanted to do. Being who I wanted to be. I believe that's one definition of happiness.
See you later, Ciri.
Take care of yourself.
See, you've taken a liking to this place.
I could stay right here forever.
Okay. Chill then.
See you later, Ciri.
Take care of yourself.
Nice. Now Ciri's here. Cool. And I almost died. I'm gonna see what our good old friends left for us. Where was it? He said on the chamber? Oh, here we go. Mutagen generator. Dear Geralt, if you are reading these words, it means I am already far beyond the borders of Toussaint, and you have found my mutagen generator. Of course, you may dub this instrument however you like, perhaps something more fitting to your taste or better reflecting its function, for I have no doubt your knowledge on the subject of mutagens is far more profound and thorough than mine. I've been working on this device in my spare time, but now it is finished, and I am convinced as an inventor can be before his invention has been used as intended, of the usefulness of this apparatus. You are surely wondering what function it is meant to serve. As the name indicates, the mutagen generator generates mutagens. It operates by absorbing electromagical energy waves from bodies, in this case the bodies of the monsters and evildoers you kill, and when it has absorbed enough as to be charged to a critical amount, the mutagen generator changes the stored energy into greater mutagen, which I suspect you will make good use of. As you surely understand, I am an amateur engineer, which is why you must forgive the lack of an ability for you to direct this operation. Which mutagen emerges as a result is determined at random, meaning chance will decide if it is a green, red, or blue mutagen. Chance, yet I have noted the colors tend to alternate by and large. I trust you shall find my gift useful. Your dearly devoted friend, Emiel Regis Rohelic Terzieff Godefroy. P.S. You might be wondering why I decided to toss the mutagen generator into your home instead of simply handing it to you in person. Well, you must know I did it out of modesty. Believe it or not. Take care, Geralt, and may my gift serve you well. Thanks, bro. Alright. Sweet. Good stuff. Okay. Well then. Let's go back up to Ciri, and then we can truly call it finished.
Even a horse drops if you ride it at a constant gallop.
Ah. All right. Well, this is it. Good night.